Welcome to another inorganic chemistry lesson. This time, we'll discuss what are and how to write decomposition reactions. Basically, a decomposition reaction is a reaction in which a compound breaks down into two or more simpler substances. The general form we can write for a decomposition reaction is AB reaction arrow A plus B. Most decomposition reactions require an input of energy in the form of heat, light, or electricity. Let us look at some decomposition reactions and analyze them. First, we have water decomposition. This reaction occurs due to an electric current being passed through the water. Hydrogen and oxygen gas are produced in this reaction. Water is a binary compound, and all binary compounds are composed of just two elements. When they undergo a decomposition reaction, always two separate elements forms. Next, we have magnesium hydroxide decomposition, where magnesium oxide and water form. When we have a decomposition reaction where we decompose hydroxides, which are, in other words, a base, always a basic oxide and water are produced. When we are writing decomposition reactions, our reagent is always in the solid state and not in the aqueous solution. Lastly, we have salt decomposition. There are a lot of decomposition reactions where salts are involved, but our scope for this lesson will be about the most common reactions where salts have a carbonate or sulfide ion in their composition. In this reaction, calcium carbonate decomposes into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. And in the second one, magnesium sulfide decomposes into magnesium oxide and sulfur dioxide. So in decomposition reactions with carbonate or sulfide salts, always a basic oxide and CO2 or SO2 are produced. If you have trouble with identifying compound class, oxidation states, or balancing reactions, I already covered these topics in my videos, and I leave links for these lessons in the description. Now it's time to write some decomposition reactions. Let's look at the first example, where we need to write mercury to oxide decomposition. Because it is a binary compound, we know that only pure elements will form in this reaction. So we can write Hg plus O2. Do not forget that oxygen is a diatomic molecule, so we always write it with index 2. All that's left is to balance the equation by writing 2 in front of HGO and Hg. Next is sodium chloride. Once again, we have a binary compound, so the product should be pure sodium and chlorine. Chlorine, like oxygen, is a diatomic molecule. To balance the reaction, we write 2 in front of NaCl and pure Na. Now we have a decomposition reaction of silver carbonate. What are the products for this reaction? Well, our reagent is salt with a carbonate anion, so basic oxide and carbon dioxide should be produced. In this case, our basic oxide is AgO, where the silver oxidation state is plus 1, and oxygen is always minus 2. So our actual chemical formula is Ag2O. Do not forget to write oxidation states and swap charges with subscripts to get the correct chemical formula when writing compounds. And the second product of this reaction is CO2, which I mentioned before. In this case, we don't need to balance the reaction because we have an equal amount of the same atoms on both sides of the reaction. Let's write the products for aluminum hydroxide decomposition. When we decompose hydroxides, basic oxide and water are always produced. What is the formula for basic oxide? Well, aluminum has an oxidation state of plus 3, and oxygen is minus 2. So we swap charges with subscripts and get Al2O3. We also add the water molecule as the product for its reaction. To balance the chemical reaction, we write 2 in front of the aluminum hydroxide and free in front of the water molecule. In aluminum sulfide decomposition reaction, methyl oxide and SO2 gas are produced because aluminum sulfide is a salt with SO3-2- ion in its composition. Once again, we get aluminum oxide and also add sulfur dioxide gas. To balance the reaction, we add the coefficient 3 in front of the SO2 molecule. What about the decomposition of calcium hydroxide? We get calcium oxide and water. The calcium oxidation state is +2 because it is in the second A group, and oxygen is -2. +2 and -2 oxidation states cancel each other out, so our formula is CaO and not Ca2O2. In this case, we don't need to balance the reaction because we have an equal amount of the same atoms on both sides of the reaction. Our last problem today is the decomposition of Na2CO3. We have salt with CO3-2- anion, so we get sodium oxide and CO2. Sodium is +1 and oxygen is always -2, so our chemical formula is Na2O. Like in the last example, we don't need to balance this chemical reaction. And that's it for today's lesson. Like always, please like and subscribe for more chemistry content. And like always, I will leave few exercises with answers that you can try to do on your own. And see you in the next lesson.